I'm working on Orpheo and Eurydice with John Fulljames. So we are directing it together, and I'm also doing the choreography.
In an opera like Gluck's Orphée et Eurydice, which is all about community ritual, it's all about how groups mourn. And that seems to be exactly the territory that Hofesh has specialized in as a choreographer.
The music is very simple and very, very beautiful. And the way it works, sort of in contrast, but also brings different colors from my choreography, from my movement style. I really love that, you know, it really throws my movement into a different direction. It's a very, very simple story, which I really like in the sense of working on it. You know, it has a very simple structure to it.
It's almost a monologue. There's one tenor, one man, Orphée, who has lost the love of his life. And it's about his process of grieving. We're thrilled to be welcoming Juan Diego Flores back to the Royal Opera House to sing this extraordinarily demanding role. Gluck writes stratospherically high for the tenor voice. He's really at the extremes of his voice as he struggles against the forces of the underworld to win back the love of his life, Eurydice, played by the wonderful Lucy Crowe.
Sir John Eliot Gardner is conducting, which I just couldn't believe it when I've been told that, because he was, he still is, but he was my hero when I was sort of 18, 19 years old.
We're very happy to be working not only with John Eliot Gardner's fantastic Monteverdi Choir, but also his own orchestra, the English Baroque Soloists. They're specialists in this repertoire. It will be fantastic to hear this music on early instruments in this opera house.
I think we are really looking to give a very raw experience that really concentrates in its heart on the music, which is in the heart of the story of Orfeo being a musician, and that's his tool in the world, his power, his energy. So yeah, music and movement really in the center of that piece, and I think it's going to be very exciting.